Hello students, welcome to the first class of Web Technology and its applications. I am Pragati Hegde, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Information Science and Engineering at Kendra Engineering College. Let us discuss about the objectives of this course. The first main objective of this course is to make the students understand and learn the semantic structure of web languages such as HTML and CSS. In the second objective, students will be able to learn how to create forms and tables using HTML and CSS. In the third objective, students will be able to design client-side programs using JavaScript and server-side programs using PHP. Fourth objective is where the students will learn the different object-oriented programming capabilities of PHP. And in the last objective, the students will be able to learn the concept of JavaScript frameworks such as jQuery. Next, we'll see the outcomes of this course. So at the end of this course, students will be able to apply all the HTML and CSS syntax and rules to build the web pages. Also, they will be learning how to create tables and format the tables and forms using HTML and CSS. Also, at the end of the course, they will be able to develop client-side scripts as well as server-side scripts. And they will learn to apply the principles of object-oriented development using PHP. So this is the textbook which you need to refer for web technology. We have one textbook, that is Randy Connolly is the author. Fundamentals of Web Development, first edition, you can refer. So we'll begin with the first module. So let us see what is HTML and where did it come from. So earlier we had ARPANET, Advanced Research Projects Agency Network, in the year 1960s. So this was the first network being developed. It was used to implement the TCP/IP protocols. So it was basically a type of WAN, Wide Area Network. So this later led to the invention of internet, what we use today. And from internet, we have moved to web, that is World Wide Web. So what is web in a computer? Web consists of web pages or websites stored in web servers that are connected to a local computer through the internet. So there is a difference between web and internet. See, internet, there is network of devices such as laptops, computers, tablets, etc. For example, like you can send an email to your friend. But web is network of servers over the internet. So suppose you type a URL in your browser, www.google.com, means you are sending a request to a web page. You are requesting for a web page from your computer using the browser. So that request will be sent to the web server, that is the Google server, and it will render that web page to your web browser. So we are going to discuss mainly about HTML. So HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. All of you know that. So it is the official language of World Wide Web. And the first specification of HTML was developed in the year 1990 by Tim Berners-Lee. And later on, you had different specifications like HTML 2.0, 3.0, 4.0, etc. So HTML's codification is given by W3C, that is the World Wide Web Consortium, in 1997. Now, HTML is defined as a markup language. So what is a markup language? Markup language is simply a way of annotating a document. Annotating means you're adding notes which give some explanation or comment to the particular term used in the document, which will help the readers to understand easily. So here you have an example. You can look at this figure. So if suppose an author writes a book and is in the last stage of printing the book, then in the earlier days, he has to specify in each page that he needs this as a main heading. So it should look bigger in size. Then this should be second heading, which should be smaller in size compared to main heading. Then he has to specify right here, these lines of paragraph should be bulleted like that. Then some words should be circled. So everywhere he has to write. So imagine he has to write for all the pages. So it's like annotating. So markup is a way to indicate information about the content. So the information about content in HTML is implemented via tags. So you have certain tags available in HTML where you can provide information about the content. So here in the previous slide, the markup consists of the red text. You can see the red text here and the various circles and arrows on the one page and little yellow sticky notes on the other. So usually like this, the author need to write it each time. But now because of HTML, everything has been easy. So what is the W3C? So W3C, World Wide Web Consortium, is the main standards organization which mainly develops the web standards. So it actually produces the recommendations. Recommendations means the specifications, different specifications we have. It begins with HTML 1.0, then 2.0, now HTML 5.0. Okay. And in the year 1998, it also brought another specification, that is XHTML 1.0, which was a version of HTML with the stricter XML, extensible markup language syntax rules. So it is a HTML as well as stricter XML, which is used to develop XML applications. So XHTML is the goal of XHTML with its strict rules was to make page rendering by forcing the web authors to create web pages without syntax errors. So that was the main goal, to create web pages without syntax errors. So there are certain rules, like here, there must be a single root element. Element names can't start with a number. Element and attribute names need to be case sensitive. Attributes you need to specify within quotes. All elements must have a closing element, or it should be a self-closing. In XHTML, we have two versions. One is XHTML 1.0 strict, so which is having very strict specification. XHTML 1.0 transitional, more forgiving flavor of XHTML. So it was meant to act as a temporary transition. Standards, movement and validators. So during this 2000 year, the focus in the professional web development community was on standards. So that is on limiting oneself to the W3C specification. So a key part of the standards movement was the use of HTML validators, where you can verify your web page's markup using the rules for this XHTML transitional or strict. So you can validate the particular web page. So one example is, you need to type the URL in the browser, W3C validator. When you type that URL, it will move to this page, markup validation service. So here address, you can specify that HTML file, that web page, and then click on check. It will validate whether it satisfies all the follows, all the syntax and rules of the XHTML. XHTML 2.0 and what WG. So later XHTML 2.0 was proposed, which overcomes the drawbacks of HTML and XHTML 1.0. So at the same time, a group of developers at Opera and Mozilla, they formed the what WG group within the W3C. So what WG means Web Hypertext Application Technology Working Group. So this group was not convinced that the W3C's embrace of XML and its abandonment of backwards compatibility was the best way. Thank you.